You cannot afford to miss a single moment of the next hour. Get ready to have your ideas about sexuality, love, and relationships blown wide open. It's time to get educated, entertained, and enlightened, as well as sexually empowered. You've now tuned into the Tantra Love, Sex, and Intimacy Show with your host, Tanya Diamond.
Have you noticed that people are still having sex? All the denouncement had absolutely no effect. Parents and counselors constantly scorn them.
Wow, okay. this is our new intro. What do we think about that?
People are still having sex.
No matter what, they are doing that. You know why they're doing that?
Because it's fun?
No.
Oh, sorry.
It's a biological imperative.
Right.
Yeah.
We have to. I can't help it.
Well, that's actually very true. And, I mean, people manage to help it. Or not help it as it may be. But
sure about that.
Yeah. But you know what? Most people are not having sex because it's fun.
They're doing it because they have to.
Well, they're driven to it.
Honey, I have to.
Well.
This isn't a choice.
This is kind of like what that's all about, right?
Yes, I agree. The biological urge, whether it's sane or not, to just find it, hunt for it, go wherever they can to get it.
Yep. It's kind of crazy. And we have, how long has it been since we've been on the air live?
A while.
We've had a few like pre-records. Why? Oh, that's right. Because not only did I come down with the flu. Then I came down with the swine flu. Like 2.5 weeks after the flu.
Okay.
So I've been flued out to the max, not being able to speak at all.
And
then
it was the holiday here in the States.
Well, that's right, Thanksgiving.
Yeah, that was one of the weeks.
We were thankful.
Yes.
Not really, but I wasn't thankful.
We're thankful to be back.
I'm a humbug, by the way.
You're a humbug?
Just listen to me. Do I sound as enthusiastic?
You don't sound that enthusiastic about the holidays.
Woohoo. It's the holidays.
So, what's the deal with that,
it's
Tanya?
It's like the only time I'm not grateful.
Whatever.
Everybody's so grateful. Why do I need to be?
Right. We're going to have to work on your manifestation around the holidays.
I don't know what's up with it. It's really horrid, too, because every year I tell my relationship person, I don't do gifts. I'm tired of this commercialism, all this like obligation and all that stuff. What is up this? What's up with that? So then, they're like, sounds good.
Oh, I see what's coming.
Oh, no, it's bad. It's bad. And then the night on Christmas Eve, I get excited. Oh, wow, it's Christmas Eve. And I go out and I buy like hundreds
of
gifts. And then the next day, I'm all excited and there's like hundreds of gifts under the tree.
There are two people in trouble.
That's right. And I'm like, oh, look here. And he's opening them and he's opening more and everything. And I love giving gifts and I'm really good at it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then I'm sitting there and I'm smiling because it's all fun. And then it's like,
all
the gifts are gone. And then he looks at me and he goes, well,
you said not
you
to get
told
you any
me
gifts.
Weren't buying gifts. And I'm like, oh.
But what I really meant to say, but
no,
can't.
No. I really mean it.
Really
I do mean it. So, yeah. I don't pout too much.
I would much rather just be given a list.
No doubt.
This is what I would love you to get me. One of the things or three of the things on this list and make them these three things.
Get me these three
Let's
things.
Let's get specific.
Right. I think lists are great. I think lists are really, really important and really great. And what we actually do in our house is we have wish list notebooks. So all year long, you are, writing in the website and the product number, whatever. You're doing your wish or you're doing a printout and pasting it in your book. So at any given time, anybody in your family can go to your wish list book for a gift for birthdays or Valentine's Day or Christmas or whatever it is.
When I write my wish, it has to be something that other people can read?
Yeah.
Oh, right.
That's helpful. You can just print it out and paste it in there. Then they can read it.
Right.
And then, so that's that way it's clear.
Right.
There it is.
Legible,
there's something.
Pictures, where to find it.
Right. Sizes, all the pertinent information. I think that's cool.
Can I have a separate book that I just write things I wish from my lover?
Well, probably. Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. You can have your family wish list book and your lover
in
wish list.
In my fantasy
book, doesn't
wish
it?
List book.
Yeah. And then the things that'll never really happen, but you want to write them down because maybe they could. that's all. It's all good. So we have in the last 3 weeks, even though I've been sick, we've had plenty to do. I've moved my house. We've moved to an apartment and it's just really cool. We're loving our space and we are, we've created, we've got brand new websites that are about to come out and new workshops next year, an entire new program of modern Tantra.
entire new program, new structure, new format.
Right, right. It's really, really exciting. We don't have a launch date yet, but just letting everybody know that, you know, we're looking to the beginning of next year to launch all this. So Modern Tantra.
Modern Tantra, mastering your life through Tantra.
Right. It is the modern path to the ancient philosophy.
I love it.
And we actually have, you know, 5 signature workshops and a couple specialized couple workshops.
Mm-hmm.
And we've got 4 classes. So my entire class and workshop format is about to be restructured and changed. And I'm just super excited.
Stay tuned.
I know. It's exciting. And we'll be blowing all this off, launching all this with some contests on the radio.
Radio contests.
Giveaways. I know. So if you,
I'm excited.
I know. You're listening all over the world. Let me tell you, we're going to have some great stuff, including giving away like free consults with me over Skype and different workshop things and possibilities and our products. And
we're going to be having webinars and seminars and classes recorded. And if people actually want to win the opportunity to receive those downloads or what have you, it's great stuff. I'm very excited about what we're creating.
Yay! Anyway, I love to do new projects, and this is definitely a brand new big project. Mm-hmm. And Max is working hard at all the technical stuff behind the scenes with I as we're doing
all
our new graphics. Yeah, we've got a new logo.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
it's got just the logo. You've been busy.
Busy. Definitely busy. And the book finally at the publishers. I don't know what happens.
The famed book is now at the publishers.
It's been at the publisher. Now it was back. Now it's back at the publisher.
Yeah, that's great.
Yeah. So, you know, I was hoping to have that all, you know, sewed up by the end of the year as a Christmas present. But
you don't like presents.
I know. I do like presents. I like presents. I'm just a pain in the butt around
Christmas.
You'll
have to give me that list.
I know. The list. Just whatever it is. No, like, sweatshirts with, like, teddy bear appliques. I don't know. Do people really like that stuff? And there must be. There must be people that buy that stuff.
I'm not going to comment, because if someone bought me a t-shirt with a teddy bear applique, we'd have to talk.
Yeah. Yeah. This is not.
And I don't see you as a teddy bear kind of person.
Neither one of us want sweatshirts with teddy bear appliques, like cute teddy bear Christmas things.
Right.
No, this is not okay. Please don't do that. You are free to send us welcome cards. You're free to send Christmas cards.
Christmas cards.
You know, Tanja at learningtantra.com. Tanja at learningtantra.com.
Mm-hmm.
That's always fun. All right, so you have notes there. What do you have notes about?
I had some notes. I mean, you know, what are we talking about? We're getting into the holidays. There's some economic stress happening.
Yeah.
And some of the common things that are coming up is connection.
Well, that's always coming up.
True. How to stay connected with stress, how to stay grounded.
You want to stay connected with your stress?
No. When there is stress, how to stay connected with the person you're in relationship with.
Oh, all righty.
When one or both of you is freaking out.
Wow, this is so weird that we're talking about this today, Joshua.
Funny you should mention.
There's been a little bit of that at our house.
A little bit of stress?
Well, you know, a little bit of upset and disconnect at our house.
A little bit of upset.
Yeah, well, you know, with the move and all the big things happening.
What's happening is always the illusion of what's happening.
Well, there is that, yeah.
It's not, the map is not the territory. What's going on in front of me is not what's really going on.
What?
In the big picture of things.
What?
Well, how many times in your life have you experienced moments where there was stress? And after the stress and the issue was done, it was no longer stressful.
Well, see, the deal is I don't actually believe in stress.
Well, just go with me on this
one. Okay. All right. And then I'll talk about that. All right. So,
How many people experience stress, and then after the stress is done, whether the issue itself is completely resolved or only beginning to be resolved, the stressful moment is done, and what happens? Do we stay stressed, or do we reconnect? We reconnect.
I don't know. Typically, some people stay stressed.
Well,
I'm sorry, I'm blowing it for
when there's
here.
A crisis, someone's freaking out,
right.
Someone's arguing, someone's getting scared, upset,
something
cantankerous, bitchy, whatever you want to call it.
Right.
After the fact, whatever it was that caused them to go into crisis, an explosion, they come back to being a little more sane, a lot more sane.
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, to remember, if I'm ramping up into stress, to breathe. Do you mention that from time to time?
I do. Yeah, breathe. Breathing is good.
And maybe even remind myself, you know what? When this pinnacle of stress is over, I'm going to be okay.
This is a temporary condition.
Temporary condition. And if I don't blow up at the people that are around me, when those times when it gets through are done, I make fewer apologies.
Well, there's always that. Yeah.
I hurt fewer feelings.
Yeah.
And I learn something. Wow. I don't have to freak out every time I'm freaking out.
I could just not freak out while I'm freaking out.
What a concept.
I could try that.
Maybe I can even say to the people around me, I am really stressed. I am freaking out. And they'll look at me and go, you don't look like you're freaking out. I know, I'm trying a new thing here.
Well, you've heard about our freak out bell at home.
Oh, yes. So, I remember that.
Yeah, there's
Has three anybody had that lately?
Yeah, I had it on my desk for a while. So there's three of us, and we have three bells. And the bells usually sit in a neutral place. They're these little tiny bells that you go tinkle, tinkle, tinkle. You know, when one of us becomes stressed to the point where, you know, even like to believe in stress, we become freaked out to the point where we're not really ourselves.
Right.
We grab the bell and ring it, and then we put it on our desk, put it somewhere close to where we are. So you can look over and go, ooh, bell's on Tanya's desk.
Right.
Okay. We are not all, none of us are allowed to freak out at the same time.
So if someone goes to grab their bell and there's not three, they're not allowed to take it?
That's right. They have to look around for the one. So now let's say the bell is on my desk.
Right.
Because I'm in
freak out. Can I go grab it and take my turn?
No. You would if you were freaking out, you would have to convince me that your freak out need was bigger than the one I was having right now.
Nice.
Because I have the bell.
Right, right, right.
So if you could talk to me in a way that told me that your freak out was pretty big and you really deserve to have the bell, then I would give you the bell and I would be done freaking out and then you would freak out.
You would take a break on freaking out.
Right, exactly.
Okay.
So now, you know, by the first of all, when you have to walk over to get the bell, you have to acknowledge you're freaking out.
Kind of, yeah.
So then usually in our house, that means you need to start breathing.
Yeah.
So we start breathing. And sometimes just the act of walking over to get the bell and breathing means you don't really need the bell anymore.
Interesting. If you can think clearly enough to go get the bell.
Right.
Right.
And then, of course, if you have the bell on your desk and somebody else is negotiating to get the bell, during that negotiation, most of the time people stop freaking
out. You're communicating and connecting.
Right.
Yeah. Interesting.
So, you know, there's a thought. Here's my thought on this. My thought that basically is it's the lack of, you know, which comes first, the chicken or the egg, right? I completely believe, and this is based on personal experience here, as a woman, that's what I am, at least
as a woman, I appreciate
week, as a
that
woman.
You're giving that opinion.
Thank you, as a woman.
That helps me when you clarify that piece.
Perfect.
I think.
That it is the lack of daily or semi-daily connection that causes all the freaking out in the first place. So, women need intimacy, right? We know that. We talk about that all the time.
Right.
Intimacy can be as simple as a touch across the back of her shoulder as you walk by as a man.
I love that.
Right. Intimacy can be as easy as just stopping, putting your hand on her face, and saying, I love you from the heart, not love you as you're walking by.
Love you, babe.
Yeah.
Give her a...
Love you, babe. Yeah, that's...
smack in the face, another hand on the...
On the bottom,
on the tush,
yeah, I don't, yeah, no. Not so much.
But actually a gentle, loving touch to the face.
Right. A kind word, you know, she catches you looking at her, you know, from across the room, and you give her a big smile, and it's like, you know, you're more beautiful than when I met you. You know, something similar. If, we're big for micro practices. That's what we're all about, is the micro practices. And that means tiny little practices throughout the day, not waiting for, you know, the Saturday. Most people like have, you know, date night.
Right.
They save it all up for date night. And it's like, by the time date night gets there, you're so empty. The, you know,
Small investments.
There's kind of like two cups.
Yeah.
I think there's two cups. There's your personal cup and there's your relationship cup. Now, if your personal cup is empty, that's your responsibility to get in there and start working on it.
If your personal cup is empty, meaning if I'm feeling empty, I'm responsible for making myself feel fulfilled.
Right, right. So there's the relationship. So there's the personal cup. If your personal cup is empty, it doesn't matter how full your relationship cup is.
Okay.
It's not going to balance out.
Right.
So you have to be personally taking care of yourself first. So if your personal cup is full, but your relationship cup is empty, that's not so good for the relationship. You're still going to be hanging in there pretty well, and it gives you enough reserves that you can step into starting to be, need to fill the relationship.
You're doing
cup.
Things to make yourself feel good, feel happy, feel productive, successful.
Right.
And then you can turn and do something with the relationship.
Right. So both people need to be adding to the relationship cup.
Okay.
So there's not two relationship cups. There's one relationship cup
right.
that you both add to.
Okay.
All right. Now, sometimes somebody's adding more than the other because they're in a better space.
Right.
That's okay.
So long as there's some give and take.
That's right. So the micro practices, if both people are doing these micro practices throughout the day, you stay more connected. And if a woman is staying more connected in her heart and her feeling, she's more apt to be open to more sex.
Mm.
So if men generally show love through having physical connection, most women, if they're empty in the relationship cup, are not really game for that.
Right.
So they kind of have some resentment, some begrudges, you know, not a great feeling about it. And if the man tries to bring it all at once, he can't get the cup full enough.
Well, yeah, if he, you know, if it gets to Saturday night or they're hanging out watching TV and then it's time for bed and then it's like, hey, honey, how about some? It's going from negative, you know, negative 10 to, hey, baby, let's go. And she don't even want to hear baby, let alone where to go.
Right, exactly. Exactly. So, and I think what happens is, so let's say you've had these times where the cup's empty.
Mm-hmm.
And then you try to, you know, fill it. Both people show up in genuine effort, right? Mm-hmm. And there's a little trickle in the bottom of it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? But if it goes now, again, for a long period of time, with no practices, that cup gets negative. I mean, there begins a crack, a little micro fissure
right.
in
now,
the
realize,
cup.
We're calling practices daily affection.
Right. Right. And, micro practices of daily awareness and affection to your partner and your relationship. And I'll talk more on that in a little bit. But so you get this little micro fissure in the bottom of the cup. Now, as you try to fill it once a week, there's a tiny little crack in it.
Ooh, right.
So you're kind of losing maybe, you know, and then another week, 2 weeks go by.
Yeah.
The crack gets a little bigger.
Yeah.
4 weeks go by because every time you stay disconnected for a period of time, you get it gets wider and bigger and deeper. It's harder to fill.
The chasm.
Right.
The chasm that separates us when love is failing.
Right. And it isn't love that's failing.
True.
You know what? It's not.
Relationship.
See, that's what people think. It's love that's failing. And what it is, it's the daily practices. It's the connection that's failing.
Right,
everything else gets in the way. Do you know how many things can get in the way of the average relationship?
A lot.
Everything.
Yeah.
Everything you let,
and
right?
The more things that get in the way, the more you have to be really conscious about making those contributions.
And I think women go to a place of loss of romance, despair. They become romantically depressed.
Now, there's one of the things I want to touch upon in this as we talk about micro practices and we gradually lose that romance or connection is when we treat other people better than we treat each other.
Oh, yeah.
You know?
Yep. I have a perfect example of this. I remember once that, you know, my partner and I had just been having all sorts of kind of, I mean, we're just totally disconnected, right? There was always something. Now, my life is really big. Mm-hmm. And in a really big life, you always have a million things happening that you could make bigger than your relationship.
Mm-hmm.
That's just how it is.
Right.
So you run your own business, you've got this, you've got that. But I remember sitting there and my partner picked up a phone call and was talking to a friend.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I saw him light up.
Oh, hey, how you doing?
I know. Yeah. You know, he like lit up.
Oh,
and
doing
he
great,
was
doing great.
Animated and, you know, excited about the conversation.
All
and
right.
He was laughing. And I was like, wow, you know, we actually haven't talked like that.
Or how come he doesn't talk to me that way?
Right. I mean, it was really kind of like, wow, that's
how many people experience that?
Yeah. Probably a lot.
Yeah.
You know, or you the classic thing is seeing your man look at somebody else with a glint that he hasn't looked at you with
in a long time. Yeah.
Right. You know?
Yeah.
Now, women generally don't get caught doing that.
Mm-hmm.
But we do it.
Mhm.
You know? So
much more sneaky about it.
Yeah, it's there. Well, women are more likely to get an emotional fix.
Right.
You know, so women are more likely to start chumming up with conversations that are, you know, so in the same token, a man could be listening to his woman talk to a friend and she is divulging things he didn't even know she was thinking about. And he could be thinking, I didn't know that.
And oftentimes she's doing that in private, so he's not even aware.
Probably.
That her needs aren't getting met, other than the fact there's a lack of connection.
Right, right. So there's all of these issues, and I'm going to come back to the same thing. People will say, well, when our kitchen is clean, when our house is remodeled, when we have enough savings, when we have this, when we have... You know what? If you keep putting everything in front of the relationship, the relationship will not be there.
Right.
Micro practices of connection throughout the day And I'm talking every flipping day. I mean, people would be like, what? Every day?
I have to be nice to her every day?
Yeah, weird, huh?
Yeah. You know, if we wrote a contract when we first met each other, of like a recording of the first month of how we behaved with each other.
Right.
And that was a contract.
Right.
Okay. I called you this often mm-hmm. and I said these nice things to you.
Well, you know what? Women, I'm sorry, but that is really a setup for women. The first 3 months, men tend to really pour it on.
Yeah.
You know, and there's all the texts and the romance and mm-hmm. all the rest of the mm-hmm. stuff. Women assume that it's going to stay that way.
Yep.
Okay. Now, men can complain too.
Yep.
You know, because the oral sex thing, right? We
yep.
always hear about that. The women pull out the oral sex
in
the beginning.
Tell you what, I'll send you a text message. You start giving me more oral
right.
sex.
And then inevitably that kind of fades out. What comes first, the chicken or the egg? Women are not as physically interested in mm-hmm. doing anything when their romance needs are not
mm-hmm.
being met.
Mm-hmm. And I think people should speak much more directly about it early on in a relationship.
No, we've definitely talked
about
that.
You and I both talk about people being blatantly direct about what they do and don't want in a relationship and scare that person away.
Joshua, are you looking at yourself in this window?
I am looking at my expressions over your shoulder.
We have a window here that the blind's up on, and Joshua, I swear, look, I'm looking back here. He is enjoying himself in the window there.
Well, because otherwise the reflection is the back of your head, and that just doesn't, you know,
do
as
down
much
the
for me.
Blind there, Joshua.
It's too distracting.
So I'm not feeling seen. I'm not feeling,
feeling
really connected
seen?
With here because he's staring at himself in the
oh,
window.
Oh, right.
Ugh.
I
see?
Apologize. See,
those are the
hang
kind
on,
of things
give me a moment
happen.
To breathe.
See, there's an authentic communication. I'm
where's
asking
your bell?
Where's Where's my bell?
Bell?
Where's
well, I'm
my
not
bell?
Really
she wasn't
freaking
out, but now, yeah. now I'm looking at you, Tanja.
Thank you. See,
and,
now we're having an authentic
and
exchange.
I thank you for letting me know what you needed in that moment so that I could give that attention to you.
Right. See, this is role model. It can actually be this easy,
mm-hmm.
you know, but people get too wound up and they wait until they're freaked out and frustrated. And then they're like, it'd be more like, Josh, you never look at me anymore.
I'm easily distracted by shining objects and my head is glaring in the window. I'm bald if you guys didn't already know this.
Yeah, so yeah, his head is actually shining.
Shaved, shiny bald.
Glaring in the
yeah,
in the
so
spotlight.
You could lower the
I could put my shades on,
there.
It might help me.
Yeah.
So anyway, it can be that easy that people actually have a conversation where mm-hmm. I could say to him, you know, I notice that you're looking at yourself a lot more than
right.
you're looking at me. I'm feeling really sad here. I don't feel like I'm pretty
I don't
anymore.
Feel loved.
Right. And then he can, yeah. So that was just an example of how you can bring
yeah.
an authentic conversation. And you can,
I
you
tried
can
that.
Enjoy yourself.
I tried that
really...
once in a challenging moment in relationship, though.
Right.
And we were struggling in connection. So, you know, my partner at the time was on the phone with, a client and, you know, was buoyant and uplifting and positive and, you know, great. Yeah. Looking forward to seeing you. Right. I'll call you when I get to the office and we'll put that on the schedule and hung up the phone. And then it was like, back to us.
Oh no.
And I was like, you know what? I notice that you don't talk to me that way almost ever. Mm-hmm. It's business. Or something's wrong, and when something's not wrong, there's just not much to say.
Uh-oh.
So if you're going to talk to me, and we were kind of in the middle of a you know, conflict.
Right.
I said, if you're going to talk to me, you need to bring some of that positive affection my way. Otherwise, don't talk to me.
Oh, what happened?
And you'll just have to suffer the fact that we don't get some of these things resolved. Okay, I was being a little bit...
I don't know.
I wasn't contributing, but I was being really truthful.
Right.
And it gave pause for thought.
Mm-hmm.
I did acknowledge, yeah, there's none of the baggage with that person, and these are clients, so we got to put the face on even if we're bummed out.
Mm-hmm.
And we don't have the baggage with those people. But you know what? I'm the one you're in relationship with.
Right. Yeah.
And the way you want me to talk to you is the way I want you to talk to me.
Could you imagine? She's like, so, hey, Joshua, I'm really happy to see
I'm
you
really
here, and you're such
you,
a jerk. I can't even believe that you're such a stupid jerk, but I just want you to know that, and I'm really looking forward to giving you up for later when we get home. Have
absolutely.
A great day.
Yeah.
Joshua's never a jerk.
No, I have my moments.
Guess what we get to do today?
What do we get to do today?
I get to do something really exciting.
Yeah?
I get to... Where'd it go? There it is. I get to actually, we have a radio sponsor.
Really?
Yeah.
Tell me all about it.
We have AdamandEve.com is sponsoring.
I love AdamandEve.com.
Do you love AdamandEve.com?
I love. I've been to their website. I have enjoyed browsing. I've got to pick out my sample products.
Oh, you get sample products.
Yeah, we have to talk about this.
Wow, you mean we're going to bring them in here and are we going to try them out? That'd be a little. Well, I don't know what Billy would think about that. He's doing the timeout.
I don't know if you and I can try them. I mean, we can bring them here clean and describe them. But that would be something that would be an at-home trial and then a review.
Oh, at-home trial, then bring them back and review.
Hey, you guys might want to go check this out.
Well, okay, so debuting, AdamandEve.com. This is great. Okay, now they've given me something to read here, so I'm going to do
it. It's a guideline.
It's a guideline. I'm going to make it my own. You guys, just one thing you got to know. You are going to get a great deal at AdamandEve.com, so listen up. It's
Adam,
like, hey.
A-D-A-M?
Yeah, Eve.
And Eve.
Not and. AdamEve.com.
A-D-A-M.
Yeah.
E-V-E.com.
.com. Okay, everybody, I'm sure you've got that by now. All right, fellas, are you looking for something to spice up in the bedroom? Ooh. Ooh, have you been fantasizing about surprising your lover with an adventurous new toy or adult movie?
Mm.
Well, here's an offer you won't be able to resist. You can go to AdamandEve.com, and for a limited time only, you get 50% off just about any item.
I love 50%
off. That's half off. But that's not all. Oh, no.
But wait. There's more.
When you select one of your items at 50% off, you will also receive three free adult DVDs for a little inspiration.
Ooh.
Plus a free extra gift. So sensual, I can't even mention it on the radio.
Billy would probably
bleep me.
Bleep you.
That's amazing. I can't mention it on the radio?
You can't mention it on the radio.
And to top it all off, we'll even throw in free shipping on the entire order.
So free shipping, 50% off on almost everything.
Almost everything. Three free adult DVDs. A free gift that's so wow.
And the mystery gift.
The mystery gift. Guess what? And I'm not even teasing you. Ooh. This is all true. So check out AdamandEve.com today.
Now, is there a
special
code?
Offer? There is a code. Guess what? Get 50% off one item when you type in T-A-N-J-A.
That's your name.
That's my name.
Spelled.
T-A-N-J-A, Tanya, for the offer coupon upon checkout. When you do, you'll get three free DVDs and a free extra gift and free shipping. Just offer the. Just use the code.
What's the code again? At AdamandEve.com.
What's the code?
T-A-N-J-A.
We are so there. So anyway, there you have an idea now for some Christmas goodies. Mm-hmm. And you know what? You don't just have to give it to somebody else.
You can keep it for yourself.
Buy it for yourself.
Well, these are the kinds of gifts I do buy for myself.
Well, see, there we go.
But I always like to share.
Right. And if you love that and you're out there thinking, I have a business I'd like, you know, people, over 65,000 plus people worldwide listening mm-hmm. to, you should call us because, you know,
you can be a sponsor as well.
Right. And you can have me reading your sexy commercial for
Ooh.
You. And in the meantime, we're going to a break and we'll catch up with you in just a few minutes.
Okay, guys, you're up.
Are you one of the 40 million sexless couples in the U.S.? Are you wondering why having sex leaves you feeling lonely? Are you suffering from the myths of sexual dysfunction? Do you know in your heart that there has to be more than what you're currently getting out of making love? To rid yourself of sexual ignorance, get more out of your lovemaking, and find out more about spiritual sexual connection, then you need to check out www.thetantrateacher.com to receive your free copy of the ebook called Secrets of the Tantra Teacher. Don't suffer another minute without the sexual loving and ecstatic bliss you were born to receive. Get to www.thetantrateacher.com right now. That's www.thetantrateacher.com.
Did you know that you can rate this show on iTunes? The show you're listening to right now. It's true. You can leave your thoughts about the show, the topic, the guest. You can even leave a suggestion. Then, before you leave, rate the show. The hosts love hearing from you, so next time you download this show from iTunes, leave your thoughts and rate the show for the hosts and for others.
Is your sex life non-existent? Do sexual dysfunctions leave you soft? Is internet porn getting more than you are? Or are you paying more attention to porn than your partner? Have you tried talk therapy and it got you nowhere? You are not alone. You can be freed from sexual shame, guilt, and dissatisfaction. A visit to the Tantra Teacher is in order. Call now and mention you heard the Tantra Teacher on the radio and get a very special offer. Stop waiting for a miracle and call right now, 206-276-2735. Phone consultations or in person will get you the information you need to be successful in your love life. But you have to call now, 206-276-2735. Stop making excuses. Call the Tantra Teacher, 206-276-2735.
Oh yeah, that's us.
Why do you think I was staring at myself in the window? You know?
Dancing around because we're too sexy for this mic.
Too sexy for.
Yeah, I just found my reflection past Josh's shoulder.
Yeah, we put the blinds down, and then all of a sudden Tanya notices she's got a window too over my shoulder.
Look at
now
that.
I'm like, I'm feeling like you're not really paying attention to me.
I'm not paying attention to you at all.
Yeah.
Because I'm too sexy for myself. Okay. We're back. So that was actually fun doing that commercial.
That was awesome.
I think we did a lot of fun with that.
I've loved talking.
AdamandEve.com.
AdamandEve.com.
Right. Okay. Holiday shopping. That's where it starts.
Mm-hmm.
Do they send it in brown paper?
They are a wonderful company that sends it in anonymous packaging.
Anonymous packaging?
Anonymous
packaging. Is that like anonymous written all over it?
No.
Okay.
That would be obvious. The mailman and everybody else would know. UPS would be like,
come on.
Oh.
You know what? I'm sorry. All anonymous packages come from places. I mean, we all know that by now, don't we?
Well, no, but there's in the return address, there's anonymous shipping labels.
Oh, okay.
Always have a corporate name of some sort
that's
non-leading.
Okay.
To the implication of what's in the
bag.
But
it was that brown bag, that brown.
No, not the brown bag. It's not hiding. AdamandEve.com. Cooking me a hard time.
Okay. We're going to enjoy that for sure. Okay. We were talking about connection and micro practices.
Mm-hmm.
And I wanted to kind of give you an idea what are you doing?
I'm just fixing my microphone.
He's coming towards me. I don't know what's happening.
She gets concerned whenever I walk towards her.
There's not a desk in front of us anymore.
And she should be.
You know, how long has the celibacy been going on? So anyway, micropath. So here's the deal. Modern Tantra is, we've got five levels. We have five levels of knowledge to life mastery.
Mm-hmm.
And so where some of this stuff, where we're getting some of the stuff and teaching the micro practices and how they fall in is, Tantra, the beginning of these steps of modern Tantra to life mastery is level one. Tantra of awareness. And that's really kind of where you learn about the universe, energy, how we all fit into it, the big picture. Because a lot of people feel very isolated and very singular.
Mm-hmm.
And when they do that, they make decisions based on that. You know, they don't realize that their decisions are like the ripples in the pond that affect everything around them.
Okay.
So it's a broader view of energy, movement, the universe, you know, the secret, all of these things that people are talking about here, a spiritual practice. And that's whether you believe in God or you believe in a different God or you believe in deities or whatever you believe in, it all fits in.
Okay.
It's really about refining your awareness of spirituality.
Right, right.
We move up to level two, which is Tantra of Self.
Okay.
Now, Tantra of Self is about exploring yourself. It's about understanding that you are running your programs. They were programmed from the time, even a little bit before we're born, about who to be.
Mm.
A lot of us think we're individuals and we think we make our own decisions.
No.
Most of us are running our programs from our youth.
Really?
Yep. So we get to find out what those programs are and our limiting beliefs and the things that are keeping us stuck.
Mm-hmm.
We get to learn about self-love, and this is where that cup, remember I was talking about yourself, your own cup.
How to actually develop a lifestyle and habits that right. cause me to contribute to my loving myself?
Yeah.
Oh, is that what I'm working on right
yeah,
now?
Yeah, yeah. Tantra of self, Joshua.
Excellent.
That's where you are.
I'm tantraing myself.
And Tantra of self-loving, self-love, about how to fill your own cup up. What's your passion? How do you fill your life without having to be needy of other people and create that vacuum where you're trying to pull people in? Because most of us are sucking energy out of our partners and out of other people. Mm-hmm. We don't know it. It's not conscious.
Mm-hmm.
But we're empty.
Oh, absolutely.
And so Tantra Self is going through those steps of finding out all of those things that we need to be fulfilled, like living in pleasure.
Living in pleasure.
Right. Like, you know, when Max and I went shopping, we went to the thrift store to get our dishes because we decided everything in the apartment, we're calling it early chic thrift. Early thrift chic. And all these beautiful dishes. You know, it's like, oh, that's a beautiful dish, and that's a beautiful dish. Why do we have to buy a set of all the same when we could, like, have all this visual feast of all these beautiful different dishes?
Mm-hmm.
So we have all these really cool dishes. And every time I pick one up, I go, ooh, I love this one.
Nice.
You know, and it's an experience. And my favorites, I only bought two bowls. I wanted to buy an entire set of these dishes that are so incredibly cool.
Mm-hmm.
And then I thought, wow, isn't that typical of what we want to do in life?
Mm-hmm.
There's something that's is exquisite, and we want to hoard it all. It's like, mm-hmm. it isn't enough that we see it once in a while.
Right.
We just want to possess it.
Oh, okay.
Right? So, like, the box of cookies, if it tastes really good,
mm-hmm.
you just don't want one. You want the entire, you want to be, you know, gorged and beyond sated with it.
Yep, did that last week.
Right. So, this is kind of weird. That's about filling up.
Yeah.
Because we're empty in other things and we're trying to use outside things to fill ourselves up with.
Mm-hmm.
We're supposed to fill up from the inside out.
Ooh.
Tantra of self.
Is that what I'm working on?
That's right.
Mm.
Yeah. Then level three is Tantra of relations.
Mm-hmm.
And that has to do with how, now that we understand ourselves
mm-hmm.
and we understand how we're going about the world, what happens when we add other people into it? And that's friends, family, coworkers.
Add other people into it.
Right. So now we're adding other people into our lives. What do we let go of with ourselves? So a lot of times we might be going great.
What do we lose of ourselves when we add other people into it? Well, this is great. Yeah. I made a new friend last night.
Excellent.
I did.
Excellent.
Yes.
Awesome. So now you get to see, you know, a lot of us, we're feeling great. We're living our passion. We're going out there doing our thing. And all of a sudden, we add something to our life.
Right.
And frequently, we let go of something in our lives that's really important.
Well, as a guy, the moment we meet, if we meet someone we're interested in, now mind you, the person that I met is not someone that I'm looking at as a relationship, but just
friend.
A new person that I've met.
That's awesome, yeah.
Okay. But as guys, what we do is we meet a woman, and the first thing we do is we're on our best behavior.
Mm-hmm.
And what can we do to impress upon them their desire to be closer with us?
Mm-hmm.
So first off, we're trying to impress them. We're trying to essentially seduce them,
mm-hmm.
you know, even if it's a good friend, well, but, you know, we're trying to get them attracted to
right,
us.
Right, exactly.
And we stop being who we really are.
Right. Well, you know, maybe who you are just a little different. But either way, you might stop, like, you might accommodate your schedule to theirs
mm-hmm.
and stop taking a class or stop dancing or stop working out or stop doing. So there's a whole bunch of things. And maybe not right off the bat, maybe a little bit later
as
you start dating and all of a sudden, you know, you want to be together all the time, and you forget that the whole point of having your own cup full is that you bring something to the relationship mm-hmm. instead of taking something from the relationship. So Tantra of relations, I mean, how do you relate to your family? What are your beliefs about relationships?
Oh, you know, that's a whole review.
Right. And Tantra of self and Tantra of relations both contain sexual aspects of Tantra. In Tantra of self, we're talking about being our own best lover, because here's something really interesting. Most people that are single are not regarded as having a sex life.
They haven't met me. Well, so, no, continue.
Right, yeah. So most people that are single, you know, that would be the one thing. If society considers them sexless because they're single.
Right,
and
right.
The reality is you can have an amazing sex life mm-hmm. on your own.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and if we believed that, and if we practiced that, and if we really understood what that meant,
mm-hmm.
we would make different choices about relationships as well.
Yeah, well, we wouldn't be in such desperate need
right.
to connect and to touch
now,
and to have sex with someone else.
That said, I do think we're tribal. I mean, I know we're tribal, mm-hmm. and I do know that we hunger for companionship and touch of another human being.
Yes.
But that doesn't mean that you cannot be exquisitely happy, single, and on your own. So, all right, Tantra relations, you know, what's our views on sex life, our sex lives with others? What's our views on family? What's our views on coworkers, friends, all of that? So what are our obligations? Where do we start losing ourselves to please others? So level three, all about how relationships work. Tantra of relations. And level four, this is really cool, Tantra of business. And of course, that's where we start talking about how we view our finances and how we view our limiting beliefs about what kind of abundance we want to live in.
Mm-hmm.
You know, what are we doing with our careers and our business, and how can we make all that flourish?
Right, right.
And with my inner circle of people, and I have, you know, new inner circle is opening up again, coming up here in the beginning of the year.
Are you saying there are new seats open?
Yes, there are new seats open for
you. You have spaces available
yep.
for some new inner circle people.
That's right. And that happens once a year, and it's getting ready to happen February and March. So if that's something you've been waiting for and lined up and on the waiting list for, just get to know that that is about to happen.
So mid-February, March, so get your name in now.
Right.
If you're interested in inner circle program, personal coaching with Tanya Diamond.
Yep. A year-long program.
Year-long commitment, year-long opportunity, year-long of improvement.
For your life. For your life. Mastery.
Send Tanya an email.
Now, these guys, we're going to have them, we're going to be having their testimonials, actually doing a recorded conversation with my inner circle guys
mm-hmm.
that you'll be able to listen to how their lives have changed.
Mm-hmm.
In the last year, and it's really amazing.
I'm looking forward to this.
Yeah, so
interviews.
I'll let you guys know when that's coming on. Okay, so Tantra business, how to make your career, business, financial life skyrocket.
Mm-hmm.
Finally, level five, Tantra of life mastery. Because you can't get to life mastery without these steps, without these levels. You know, and people will say to me, well, you know, I think I have myself sewed up or that sewed up. You really do need to take these. They have to come at these levels because mm-hmm. each one builds on each other. And without filling the cup from inside out and coming up through the levels, you just can't get there.
And if you feel like you've already done the homework on one of the levels, it's not like testing out, but it'll be familiar territory. And you'll be able to go to those places that the questions and exercises are asking you to go.
So what we're going to do is we're going to be teaching workshops starting next year on these. So you can do level one and two in a 3-day back-to-back.
Mm-hmm.
But you have workbooks that you're going to be going home with.
Mm-hmm.
So you're going to take the workshop,
mm-hmm.
learn the practices mm-hmm. and all of that, the theories. Then you're going to take your workbook.
Right.
You're going to go home. You're going to do the practices in your workbook. When you want to register for the next level, you're going to be doing an email to us. And mm-hmm. you're going to be on a phone call with one of our coaches talking about your workbook.
Ah.
Or you'll be doing it on your personal forum in our membership site, which we'll be launching as well.
Mm-hmm.
So you're going to be, you just can't send the money in. You're actually going to have to show us and yourself
that you've done the homework, because if you show up and you know, if you get to level two workshop and we are doing breath techniques and you're like, oh, which one was that?
Mm-hmm.
I missed that class.
Right.
No, we need to value everybody's time who's done the work.
Yep.
And if you've done the work, you can go to the next class.
Right. So there'll be the levels, there'll be the steps, there'll be the membership site to back you up. There can actually be people, you know, us talking to you.
Mm-hmm.
It could be me on the phone as one of the coaches. Who knows who's going to be calling you up to say, okay, well, I've looked at your stuff here and sounds good and you're ready for level three.
If you're up for the challenge, you're ready to move on.
I mean, we're talking about serious life change here. I am not, you know, we're not messing around here.
We don't mess around when we mess around.
No. I'm not one of those people that teaches a workshop of this, what we're going to be doing here, and says, oh, that's fine, and you were great, and off you go now, and there's nothing. What mm-hmm. else are you going to do with that? We need mm-hmm. follow through.
Mm-hmm.
I am looking, and we in Team Tantra are looking to change the world, revolutionize how people think and
we're really
act and grow.
Looking to have effective change in people's lives.
Yep. So to do that, you need us behind you 100%. If we're not behind you 100% when you're doing this work, you're not going to do it.
Mm-hmm.
You're not going to go there. So I'm extremely excited about how all this is coming. There's actually two secret levels above level five.
What?
Yeah.
Now, yes. I have a question.
Yeah.
I'm going to backtrack a little bit.
Sure.
On these five levels, I heard you mention, you know, having my own sexual relationship with myself. Mm-hmm. But at what point in this do we talk about sex?
Well, level one and two. So okay. All the tantric sexual education begins in level two and three.
Level two and three.
Tantra of self and tantra of relations.
Okay, so the ancient teachings of intimacy.
Yes.
We'll be in two and we'll begin.
Yeah,
in level two and three.
Yep.
Excellent.
Yep, because you really 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 need that information too, mm-hmm. and you don't have to be in a couple to be in. By the way, the Tantra of Relations mm-hmm. is for everybody, mm-hmm. and then we have two specialized couples workshops outside of those levels for couples that want to just work together only
at
certain things.
Excellent.
So. Yes, you will learn all the tantric secret tantric arts as well. You're going to learn about, I mean, we're talking modern tantra. We're talking about taking classical mm-hmm. tantra mm-hmm. and making it applicable for today. Mach 1, cell phone in the ears, you know.
I don't drive
crazy
Mach 1
thing.
Anymore,
you don't?
By
That's
the way.
Good. That's good. And cell phone in the ear, kids, work, businesses, all the crazy stuff that we have going on now.
How to maintain connection with yourself.
Yes.
And your world and your relationship.
Yep.
With all that going on. Because I think that's what most couples are suffering from, not knowing how to maintain connection.
Most people. Most single people as well, not even connecting to themselves. Okay. I mean, their cups are empty. People are walking around on empty.
Well, my first piece of advice when I have someone who's single, they're like, you know, how do I find, you know, I'm ready for a relationship, but how do I find someone that I really feel that connected to? And I say, what are you doing for yourself?
Right.
What are you finding that's making you really excited? What are you out doing? Oh, I don't have time or energy for that.
Right. So if you don't have time and energy for yourself,
right.
What are you going to do in a relationship?
Right. I've got a close buddy, great guy, brilliant guy. And he's got good taste. He's well-educated. He has a great job. And his interests are so diverse. And he adores women. I mean, he's much better than the average chauvinist. and, you know, he keeps telling me he's going to quit smoking.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, if I go and hang out at his house, I've got to wash my clothing when I go home. And, you know, he and I were talking about relationships. And I said, dude, you are such a commodity. There are a few things you can work on, but you are a commodity. And he's like, fine, you do it. I'm like, great, I'm going to pimp you out, boy. And, you know, he's given me permission to find him a relationship. The reality is he's got to do his homework first. If he's feeling low, if he's feeling empty, one example, if he's saying, I'm going to quit smoking, is the woman you're going to be with. Do you want to be a smoker when you finally find her? And the reality is he's got to really master himself.
Right. Well, women don't want men that master them. They want men that master themselves.
Yeah.
And let me tell you. Here is a huge thing. By the way, men, listen up. This is a huge tip. Huge tip.
Listening?
Whatever comes out of your mouth, your words, you need to stick with.
Mm.
There is nothing more detrimental to a woman's psyche in relationship than hearing a man say things that he never follows through with.
Right. Better off to say no and have an argument. Or better off to not say it.
It can be as simple as, I'm going to start working out tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
And he says that and she's okay. And then tomorrow comes and it doesn't. I'm going to start working out tomorrow. I'm going to start working out next week. I'm going to do this. I'm going to do that. Because
you're better off not saying it and then just starting to work out. Honey, what are you doing? I'm working out.
Right. Right. Better yet, say it and actually do it. Because I've had a few men say, oh, yeah, okay, well, that's why I never say anything. I never say anything because, you know, I don't want to have to be stuck with,
if I know there's something I'm going to do,
right,
and I know when I'm going to do it,
right,
I may give the, you know, the foreshadow.
Right.
However, if I'm going to do something sexy like go work out, I'm going to go work out. And I, you know, if she doesn't know I'm working out and I come back, you know, sweaty and worked over, she's like, did you just work out? And I'll look at her and say, yes, as a matter of fact, I did.
Right.
And as I continue to do that, she notices the habit. She's like, you're working out. I noticed that. I'm glad you noticed that.
Right. But even as
simple. If I'm making a promise.
I'm talking, I'm even not talking things that are that big. I'm talking things about, I'll take out the trash.
Right.
You know, and you know, hey, honey, I'll grab, I'll do that.
Mm-hmm.
And then it doesn't happen.
Mm-hmm.
women, that's a really, really important thing to women. And why it is because it goes to integrity.
Right.
We need to believe in our men. Mm-hmm. So when you say you're sexy, when you tell me I'm sexy, you mean it. It's not just,
she cares to listen.
Right. Or you say, I'm really going to work on this relationship with you.
Mm-hmm.
She knows you'll do it because after all, you do everything else you say.
Right, right.
Ladies, tip for the ladies here. Big, 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 big tip. You need to trust your man. What the heck does that mean?
What does that mean?
A lot of women say, oh, no, I trust him. I've very rarely met a woman that completely trusts her man.
With his own toothbrush?
Well, yeah, sometimes they do that.
Yeah. When she packs it for him to go on vacation.
Right, exactly. What does it mean to trust our man? Well, the easiest thing is when he says you're beautiful.
Ah.
You believe him.
Right.
When he says, I love your big butt.
Mm-hmm.
You believe him.
Yeah.
Because he might really like
Into an argument. I stimulated an argument.
Yeah.
Because I wasn't being believed.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, you know what? How you feel about yourself is impacting my ability to compliment you.
That's brilliant. Yep.
And I am having a good time. In fact, I'm getting off, checking out your butt, and I am into it. And every time I tell you how much I'm enjoying myself and what it feels like or what it looks like, and this is, I am digging this experience, and you go, oh, my butt, I'm glad you're enjoying it. You are depriving yourself of experiencing the joy that I am experiencing with you.
Exactly.
And finally she was like, I think I'm beginning to believe you.
Right.
And I said, damn straight.
See, we've got to trust our men. We have to trust our men that when they say I love you, when they say you're beautiful, when they say these things, that they mean it.
Mm-hmm.
Now, given that, they need to mean it.
Mm-hmm.
And so you can see how these two things are kind of overlapping here?
They are.
So a man says, I'm going to take out the trash.
Uh-huh.
And he actually does it. Whenever he says it, he doesn't have to be reminded again or what. He actually does it, right?
Now, there's a little addendum to that.
What's that?
And let me know if I'm off track. That the loving reminders rather than the punitive reminders.
Well, she shouldn't really actually have to remind him.
Well, I know.
He's got to step up.
I know.
Got to step up. Because then otherwise you put her in the nagging position.
We'll have to discuss what to do with the other 95%.
Yeah. Yeah, that's not attractive if we have to nag.
I know.
We don't like that. So, okay.
We'll talk about that communication next time.
The man says he's going to do something. He does it.
Mm-hmm.
The woman, the man says something to the woman. She believes it.
Mm-hmm.
These things start to build.
And he has to mean it.
Yeah, guess what they start to build? Connection.
Oh,
see?
Does that mean that I get more sex?
Yeah. If you're connected with your woman, chances are she's going to want to have more sex.
Oh, okay. Yeah?
And gentlemen, you're filling up her intimacy needs into the relationship cup there, she's going to want you more.
Well, how about right that there? She's going to want you.
Yeah. Well,
When a woman is expressive and actively wanting me, that it fuels the whole relationship.
That's better than her just giving it up because she needs to. Okay. We only have a couple of minutes left, and I cannot believe this. I actually have a couple of spaces left in my Couples Empowerment Weekend Workshop this weekend.
Orcas Island.
Couple Weekend Workshop, $295 per couple.
That's about half of what it should cost.
It's usually $800.
Oh.
That's obscene. Okay. $295. It's a special for my friend Adam Farish, who owns the Outlook Inn on Orcas Island. That's where we're going to be.
Mm-hmm.
Orcas Island, Outlook Inn, Couples Empowerment Weekend. You can find it on my website at learningtantra.com. Look under workshops.
Couples Empowerment Weekend,
Orcas Island. And I'm doing a free intro to Tantra talk tomorrow night at the Outlook Inn on Orcas Island.
Friday
and
night,
free.
A free intro talk at the Outlook Inn on Orcas Island.
6:30.
6:30
p.m.
And then the workshop
is the following 2 days.
Saturday, Sunday.
Right. There's a special room rate, too, at the Outlook
Inn. So Adam has extended a special room rate in addition to the great price coming in.
Exactly. This is unheard of. Probably never going to happen again at that rate. This was a special for him. He wants to introduce me to his crowd.
Mm.
So we're there. Couples Empowerment Weekend, 2 days with Tanya. Max is going to be co-teaching with me.
Nice.
And we're leaving tomorrow morning to have a great time.
Oh, awesome.
So get to it quick. Drop me an email, send me a phone call, you know, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Phone call me even if you need to and say, please, 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 Facebook me, Twitter me, whatever.
I want to be in that workshop.
Yeah, I want to be in that workshop because we've only got a few spaces left, okay?
Now, is it just for couples or can a single go?
A single can go with a friend. that you're going to
okay,
be
single really, can go with a friend.
You have to, yeah, you don't have to be married. You don't have to be in a super big relationship if you and a friend are racy enough to come check it out. I did try to pimp you out to somebody on Facebook.
Oh, man.
So
saw that. I wonder
she's
if
she's in Wisconsin. Anywhere, Maryland or something like that. All right, what have we got left here, Billy? We are done. Okay, we will catch you all next week, and we're out.
Thank you, and have a good time.
You've been listening to the Tantra Love, Sex, and Intimacy Show with your host, Tanya Diamond. Visit her website at www.tanyadiamond.com. That's T-A-N-J-A for more information on workshops and classes.
Parents and counselors, constantly.